Oh, hey everyone, Justin here. Can you believe we drove all the way to California and Dr. Atlas isn't even here? I just got a call from his assistant though. Turns out he's on his way to Japan for some big geography conference. But he's invited me to join him. My flight to Tokyo is tomorrow, so we've got plenty of time to explore Los Angeles. And I've already noticed something interesting here. As we were driving into the city, I couldn't help but notice a haze hanging over the skyline, and there was so much traffic. I realized the haze I was seeing was smog, a type of air pollution caused by transportation and manufacturing in the area. It made me think about our next theme of geography, human-environment interaction. Through this lens, geographers observe how humans adapt to, depend on, and modify their environments, and how environmental modifications in one part of the world can have global impacts. Hold on. Is the ground shaking? Take cover! So, I just experienced my first earthquake, and I'm a bit shaken up, literally. You can't always feel them, but Southern California experiences about 30 earthquakes every day. Many buildings here are constructed with flexible materials that can absorb the shock of earthquakes, and community organizations frequently teach people how to prepare for and respond to them. These are excellent examples of how humans adapt to their environments. Environmental adaptations are adjustments humans make to better survive in their unique surroundings. Can you remember how people in New Orleans adapted to their environments? Maybe you remember the houses built with raised foundations, a way to adapt to the risk of flooding. These adaptations are crucial for minimizing damage and saving lives. But adaptation isn't just about dealing with disasters, it's also about everyday living. For instance, how might someone in this hot climate adapt to their environment versus someone in this cold climate? In a hot climate, someone might adapt by wearing light clothing and building homes with natural ventilation to stay cool. Whereas in a cold climate, people might use heating systems and build homes with good insulation to retain warmth. Geographers often work with communities to suggest strategies to adapt to their unique environments. Imagine you are a geographer helping this community in California where wildfires are becoming more frequent due to dry conditions and higher temperatures. What strategies could you suggest to help them adapt? You might suggest developing warning systems to alert residents when the risk of wildfires is high. Or you could work with local fire departments to educate residents on fire prevention, emergency preparedness, and evacuation procedures. Environmental adaptations show our resilience and creativity in the face of environmental challenges, finding ways to live harmoniously with our surroundings. While the need to adapt to our environment affects many aspects of our lives, our dependency on the environment impacts us even more. Environmental dependency is when humans rely on the environment to meet their basic needs. These dependencies can have a huge impact on everything from daily life to the economy. Take California's Central Valley, for example. It's one of the most productive agricultural regions in the world, making California's economy heavily dependent on water. However, California often experiences droughts that make water scarce. How might a prolonged drought impact daily life and the economy? During a drought, communities might prioritize drinking water over the water needed for farming, leading to reduced crop yields. This can drive up food prices and impact the local and national economy. State and local governments have implemented rules about when and how people can use water in order to conserve it. For example, many areas have regulations limiting when residents can water their lawns and gardens. This dependency on water highlights the delicate balance between human needs and natural resources. Speaking of, here's another resource we all depend on: oil. Oil powers transportation and supports manufacturing, making it essential for our daily lives and the global economy. And while so much of our world is dependent on it, it isn't going to last forever. Oil is a non-renewable resource, meaning it can't be replaced once it's all used up. Plus, extracting, transporting, and burning oil actually harms our environment by increasing the amount of carbon dioxide in the air. Because of these issues, geographers look for more sustainable solutions to reduce our dependence on this resource. Sustainability is the practice of using resources in a way that meets our needs without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs. So let's think like geographers again. What do you think we can do to reduce our dependency on oil and conserve this resource? Well, we can use alternative transportation methods like biking, walking, or even carpooling. Oil dependency has also prompted sustainable innovations in transportation like electric cars and renewable energy sources like solar, wind, and hydroelectric power. Conserving non-renewable resources by using sustainable alternatives ensures that future generations can continue to live and thrive in their unique environments. One of my favorite things about California is the palm trees. But did you know they aren't even native to this region? They were brought here from other parts of the world to give the area a unique look, helping to attract tourists and new residents. This is an example of how humans modify their environments, making changes to their surroundings to better suit their needs. This may sound similar to environmental adaptation. The difference is, when we adapt to our environment, we are adjusting to natural forces we cannot control, like flooding. When we modify the environment, we are changing the Earth's landscape, like adding palm trees to a place where they don't naturally grow. Sometimes modifications can be a result of environmental dependence and adaptation. For instance, we know that California's economy is dependent on water, and that Californians have to adapt to frequent droughts. This leads to modifications to the environment that bring water into the area. California has built extensive reservoirs, aqueducts, and pumps that transport water into its drier regions. These systems provide water for drinking, irrigation, and industry. By building these systems, they've modified or changed the environment. And sometimes environmental modifications can have global impacts. For instance, the Amazon rainforest has been impacted by deforestation for many years. The Amazon is often called the lungs of the earth because it has almost 400 billion trees and over 80,000 different plant species. How do you think deforestation in this one region is impacting the rest of the world? Remember how I said that burning oil releases harmful carbon dioxide into the atmosphere? Vegetation in the Amazon absorbs large amounts of that carbon dioxide and releases a lot of oxygen in return, which we all need to survive. As deforestation depletes these forests, less carbon dioxide is absorbed, leading to higher global temperatures and accelerating climate change. Climate change refers to the long-term shifts in global temperatures and weather patterns mainly caused by human activities. It can lead to severe consequences like rising sea levels, disrupted ecosystems, and extreme weather events like hurricanes, heat waves, and, you guessed it, droughts. As geographers, it's crucial to recognize that every modification we make to our environment has a ripple effect. But we can also make positive modifications to our environment. It could be as simple as planting a tree. These types of modifications have ripple effects too. They contribute to a healthier, more sustainable world for ourselves and future generations. All right, explorers, we're ready to check yet another theme of geography off our list. By evaluating how humans adapt to, depend on, and modify their environments, we've gained a deeper understanding of the intricate connections between people and our planet, and the critical importance of promoting more sustainable habits. Every small step we take contributes to a larger effort to preserve our environment for future generations. So, as we wrap up today, think about what you can do to live a more sustainable life. As for me, I've got to pack up for Tokyo. I'll catch up with you at the airport. Until then, keep exploring. See you next time. Hey.